guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel MotorBeast. Today I'm back here with another interesting video that is reviewing this is the Ford Figo 2012, which is this is the ZXI variant, which is the second top, and of course it's a TDCI, that means diesel. So let's start. So up front you get Ford logo with chrome badging around it and a chrome strip going here. Then below is the Fox skid plate with a place to keep the number plate. And below there is a fog lamp mount. Basically that time the companies were not giving the fog lamp. This is the towing hook, and now let me show you the headlamp of the car. So this is the headlamp. These are halogens basically, and with bulb, not LED. And now let me show you the tire. The tire is in steel wheel with the wheel cap, and the tire size happens to be 175/65 R14. They're Bridgestone tires. Now here you get these bulb. This is also bulb, not LED. You get bulb LED indicators. Then you get ORVM, which is contrast to the color. This is the side look of the car. Can't be showing the whole thing because I don't have that much of space right now. So this is the door handle, which is body colored, which gets a mucky mount, so you can just keep it and just unlock or lock your vehicle. Then you get the rear door handle, which doesn't have anything. The car is unlocked right now, so the door may open. And one more thing, there are two things I have to tell you on this side. First thing is the chrome strip running over here. This one is a part of the accessory, it's not the standard equipment. And this sun visor at the top is also, not sun visor, basically rain blocker or sun blocker is part of the stand, it's not part of the standard equipment, it's accessory. This is the rear quarter glass. The rear tire size also happens to be the same, which is 175/65 R14, and 82 is the code, I think. Again, there are Bridgestone tires. So now let's move on to the rear. So this is the rear of the car. Let me show you at a glance. So let's move the headlamps. So the tail lamps are vertical, as that time they had a design of trend of that, basically that vertical tail lamps are good. The same thing this side. The top ones, basically this is divided into three types. So this is the main tail lamp. This is kind of DRL, that means day running lamp, and this is the indicator. High mount stop lamp, rear windshield, Fox skid plate, and let me show you the exhaust of the car. So this is the exhaust, and this is how the underbody looks. You can just have a look at the Ford logo here, which is in chrome. So now let's shift to the interior. This is the view of the door. A big glass here. The handle. The power window switch. The door grab handle, so you can grab the door like this. Then this is the bucket and bottle holder and a map pocket. 1 liter badging given there. So this is how the door looks. So now let me show you the rear door. So the rear door looks somewhat like this. The glass area is big, so that you don't feel claustrophobic at all. Then you get a small quarter glass thing. If a glass was given here, it would be a nice touch. The handle. The window one. This is the normal pullover windows, not the key one. This has the grab handle and gets this premium finish over here. So now let us shift to the interior, and I will show you the interior properly. So this is the steering. This is the steering of the car. And now let me get in so that I can show you in more detail. So this is the MID. This is the MID. So at the left side it gets RPM meter, at the right side it gets a small digital unit where we can get the kilometers, the trip meter, the distance to empty, and the audio. Then this is the analog speedometer, 220 is the max speed. This is the fuel gauge. And on the steering logo, there is a Ford logo. Nice steering, no leather wraps or something, but it's nice. This is the central console. So here you get the AC vents. And here also the same type of AC vents. So this is the hazard switch button. So as this is the second topic, it gets rear defogger, so that's the switch for that. Three dummy switches, I really don't know for what. And this is the Ford's, what do we call that? That time they used to call it radio or tape or something like that. So it gets CD player there and nice switch. Manual AC controls, one switch for AC, let me show it to you. Other one is for the circulation, like the air should come or not. 4-speed AC, the climate control, and the AC, like for the leg it should come or the face and all. So now let me show you the ORVM. I mean the IRVM, I'm making mistakes. This is the IRVM. Here you get a light which is bright enough. This is the sun visor. Doesn't get any type of mirror or something. And this comes out always. This is the back passenger side with a mirror. So now let us just have a quick audio test. The audio test seems to be excellent. And this is the gear knob, 5-speed manual gears. This here are a few storage spaces, a cup holder, a key holder basically, and some storage space here. Then you get a 12-volt charging socket. This area is plain. Charging socket or something would be a good choice over here rather than giving it there. This are seatbelt mounts, the handbrake, and this is the co-passenger seat. Let me show you the glove box. The glove box seems to be big enough, and you get a cubby hold at the front. And I forgot to show the AC vents. So the AC vents look like this. And this is how the overall front interior is. You get the manual ORVM controls. And this APL pillar is basically of a good size. It's not blocking the roadway and not making a blind spot. So now let's shift to the rear. Already showed you the rear door, guys. So now let's move inside. So this is how it looks from inside. So let me get in. So before I get in, let me show you. It gets two fixed headrests at the rear with no armrest. So now let me get in and close the door. So this car has a lot of space. The front seat is adjusted to a person who is around 5 feet 6 inches tall, and but still my height is around 5 feet 3 inches, but still I have a lot of leg room here. So and 6 feet person would be comfortable. So this is the middle hump here, so I think the third passenger won't be that comfortable. You get magazine holder here, but no magazine holder here. Then let me show you the headroom. So this is the headroom. It's decent. So now let me show you the parcel shelf. So this is the partial shelf of it. This is the overall look of the whole interior. This is the grab handle with the coat hanger. The same thing here. There is no light at the rear, no sunroof. At that time there no had sunroof. And this is the look of the front dashboard. And we have, that's it for today, guys. And if you like this video, then please do like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Motor Beast, and stay tuned for the next video.